Good day, this is Jim Pytel from Columbia Gorge Community College. This is Digital Electronics 1. This lecture is entitled Unit 5 Review. What have we learned this unit? A lot. Okay, what are we going to concentrate for this particular unit? Kind of the tough stuff is taking inputs and coming up with a desired output, and we're going to use our Carnot maps to come up with a minimum SOP expression. One of the examples I left you guys to work with is make a 2 to 6 detector. I want it to output a 1, or a logical high, when it detects the presence of 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. And my inputs are going to be a binary number, a 4-bit binary number. Let's call our inputs D, C, B, and A, and let's just say output. Step 1. What are my inputs? Make all possible combinations of inputs. What's the next step? We've made our truth table. What's our next step? Think about it. What does our output look like? Well, if it's a 2, it's within our range. 3, 4, 5, 6. Too easy. What are the rest of these guys? Zeros. What's the next step? Derive the minimum SOP expression using a Carnot map. Stick it in a Carnot map. Okay, here's a bare Carnot map. How am I going to organize it? Well, my truth table is DCBA. DCBA. What are the values? 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0. Same thing here. Again, we're going in gray code. And if you want to do a cheat sheet, what is it? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. The numbers we're concerned with, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, the other ones, is 7 part of it? No, it's not. Okay, so what we're going to do is take that truth table using our little cheat sheet here and just fill out the Carnot map. 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. What's the next step? Perform the groups. Basically, I'm going to group these things in groups of 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, etc. Maximize the size of the group. What's the next rule? Minimize the number of groups. We can have groups that we must include adjacencies. Excuse me. We must include all ones. The only thing in a group must they must be adjacent to be included in a group. Sorry, it took me a while to spit that out. All right. So what is my first group I'm going to grab? I can grab that one. I can grab this one. That's a group of 2. And here's something pretty neat. I can grab this one, right? Because it's overlapping. Can I grab just this one? Yeah, I can do that, but that's wrong. Maximize the size of the group. Can I grab this one via wraparound adjacency? Yes. Which is better, north and south or east and west? Doesn't matter, okay? Because ultimately, you're going to have 3 terms for that green product term. Okay, you're going to have 3 product terms if you go this way. It doesn't matter. Which one do you want to grab? Depends. So there's 2 options with green. So what I'm going to do, and I know this is kind of going to drive you guys crazy, I'm going to do a green and a pink, but realize that I will have a choice. I'm going to have red or blue or green or pink. I've got to choose one of those. Our choice, we might have, one might be better than the other. So our output is equal to the sum of the red product with the blue product with either the green or the pink. And ultimately, it's going to have the minimum SOP expression. What is the product term for the one in red? I'm getting not D and not C and B. Why? Because it's in the not D, not C row. And it's in a column where B is always a 1. Okay, if you didn't want to do that, you could always list off B, C, B, A. Well, it's in 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0. Which are the things that matter? It looks like A doesn't matter because it can take 1 or 0. B's got to be a 1, C has to be a 0, D has to be a 0. Ultimately, it's the same thing. You're getting not D and not C and B. What's the blue term? Okay, the blue term is also in a row where not D and C, i.e. 0, 1. What is the column that it's in? Well, it's in the column where not B. What is, okay, let's try the green term and then the pink term. Okay, so the green term is going to look like this. Not D and B and not A. And the pink term is going to look like this. Not D and C, not A. Okay, so put them all together and make your choice which one you want. And it really doesn't matter. I mean, think about, you could potentially, here is a common term, not D and C. Not D and C. I could do not D and C earlier in there and just reuse it later. But just as easily, I could say not D and B. not DNB is a common term, but I could just make that one earlier and reuse it later. And just for the heck of it, I'm going to do not D and C and not A. So that is the minimum SOP expression we can possibly come up with here. What does this look like? Design a fixed function. Just take the logic gates. See what this thing looks like. Well, it's going to be product term, i.e. an AND gate, with two negated variables, being ORed with another product term with two negated variables, being ORed with a product term, i.e. an AND gate, with two negated variables. So I'm going to need one AND gate, three input AND gate, two three input AND gates, three three input AND gates. I'm going to need one inverter, two inverters, and do I need a third one? Yep, here's the third one. And do I need a fourth one? Yes. Well, some of you may be like, hey, what about that one? And what about that one? We've already got that not D term. And some of you guys may be like, hey, I can pull that thing out. No, not really. Because again, we're trying to have an SOP, sum of product terms. So let's go ahead and see what this picture looks like for this particular device. Okay, so here is a one-line diagram showing this, and I've got our red AND gate. What's that getting? It's getting not D, ANDed with not C, ANDed with B. Our blue AND gate is getting not D, ANDed with C, ANDed with not B. Finally, our pink AND gate, what is it getting? It's getting not D, ANDed with C, ANDed with not A. A pretty good example of a what I'm expecting you guys to do from the beginning to the end. Given this nebulous description, make me a 2 to 6 detector. What I want you to come up with is the output expression, the fully minimized SOP expression. We may take the next necessary step to implement this thing, this drawing a schematic. We may even take the next step is actually physically hooking these things up. We could potentially even program these things in VHDL. Okay, next thing I'd like to do actually in this Unit 5 review, I'm purposely gonna do a K-map wrong. Okay, I'm gonna show you what you should see. Okay, so here's an example of a K-map that I've taken the truth table, I've correctly put it in here, but I'm going to purposely incorrectly group this thing. There is one right way to do this thing. There are a bunch of wrong ways. Here's the first wrong way. I could forget about wraparound adjacency. I could forget about that it goes this way. And I could just say, okay, I want a group of 1, 2, 4, or 8. And I'm going to see those two groups left and right. So I'm going to grab that group and that group. What am I going to get my output? And let's say that's X. X is equal to the red product term ORed with the blue product term. What you're going to find is you're going to find an opportunity to apply one of those Boolean rules we've talked about. And it's going to stick out like a sore thumb. And you're going to have to go through Boolean simplification to get the final product, the final minimum SOP expression. The point is if you've done the K-map correctly, you're going to go there. You don't have to do this step. So let's go ahead and come up with the incorrect product terms for those red and blue. It's going to look like this, and there you go. It may not be readily evident until you put it in here. I already see something that's sticking out like a sore thumb. I'm going to have to go down to just the black pen to do this thing because it's going to drive me crazy. What's a common term? The common term I see is B and not D. B, not D, C, and all I'm doing is reorganizing it right now. B, not D, not C. Do you see something here? C or not C. I could factor out B, not D, C, or not C. What is C or not C in our Boolean simplification? It's a 1. What is something ANDed with a 1? It's B, not D. So I had to use additional steps to get there. The punchline of this is recognize when you've done your K-map wrong. I've done my K-map wrong if I have other opportunities to simplify. Okay, how did I recognize that? Well, the Boolean rules. Okay, so these Boolean rules, I know that we've got an automated method of doing logic simplification once we've got a truth table. Again, the Boolean rules have not been superseded by the K-map. You need to use the Boolean rules if you're given just the expression. The K-map is for use when you've got the truth table. You can always develop the truth table from an expression, but it may be an unnecessary step if you can use the Boolean simplification. But the point is if you've done a K-map incorrectly, you will recognize opportunities within your supposedly lowest, simplest expression to actually simplify even further. If you've done it correctly, you should come up with the simplified expression. Now let's do it correctly. Okay, there's our K-map. I'm going to grab one group of 4. What are the terms within here for that product term? Well, I see B, and it looks like not D. Oh my gosh, it's exactly what we had before. If you've done the K-map correctly, there should be no opportunities for simplification, and you will come up with the simplified SOP, minimum SOP expression. Okay, let's move on to one of our other examples, which I previously alluded to, and that is namely our segment logic. Okay, again, we are using a totally simplified version of the 7447 BCD to 7-segment display driver, and again, we are common anode. It takes a zero to light it up. What are the segments? A, B, C, D, E, F, and G. Okay, it takes a zero to light it up. Okay, we did A and B as examples. Let's do C. So where's C? Which numbers light it up? A 0, a 1, 3, a 4, a 5, a 6, a 7, an 8, and a 9. So it looks like the only thing that doesn't light it up is a 2, okay? Make the truth table, okay? Your truth table should look something like this. Okay, notice I filled it out only up to 9, because that's 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. That's, again, MSB to LSB. Because check this out, we will never get invalid data. What I'm saying is from our previous example, we will never get numbers greater than 9. They've already been excluded. So what we can do is start including don't care, don't care, don't care, don't care, don't care, don't care. Check your work. Are you satisfied? Again, what does it take for a common anode to light up? It takes a zero. Do the same thing for D. We've got this right here. All we need to do is go ahead and see which numbers light up segment D. That's being the bottom one right here. Okay, so those are our blank numbers. Which one lights up the bottom one? Zero lights it up. 2, 3, 5, 6, 8. Okay, so it takes a zero to light it up, common anode. Okay, it takes a 1 to keep it dark. 1 for 1, 1 for 4, 1 for 7, and 1 for 9. Put zeros for where it's lit up. Don't cares for those times that have been excluded. Like I said in the example problem previously, we have previously excluded all non-BCD compliant numbers. Now what are we going to do? We've got the truth tables for segment C. Got the truth table for segment D. Go ahead and put one of them in a K-map and put the other into another K-map. Don't try to put them both in the same thing, because these things are two entirely separate outputs based off the same inputs. If you think about this in a block diagram, 4 BCD numbers come in, D, C, B, A, from MSB to LSB. I'm getting 7 outputs, A through G. What's the logic for segment A? What's the logic for segment B? What's the logic for segment C, D, E, F, and G? That's what we're trying to come up with. What is the logic for segment C in this case? So make a bare K-map for C, make a bare K-map for D, fill out the K-maps. Okay, so there's your two bare K-maps. Go ahead and fill out the C truth table, populate this K-map. Take the D truth table, populate that K-map. This should look something like this. There you go. In the C segment, it's just 2, 0010. In the D segment, it's 1, 4, 7, and 9. And notice I've put those don't cares in there. Go ahead and see if you can come up. Let's just work on the C segment now. What is the groups? What are the product terms that we need? First off, how many product terms do we need? Well, we've got 1, 1. The answer is you need one product term, because you've got to account for that one. Minimize the number of groups. We just did. It's one group. Maximize the size of the groups. And that's where these don't cares come into play. So maximize the size of the group. Yeah, I could do that, but I'd be wrong. Because check it out. I've got an opportunity to go ahead and include that group. I'm maximizing the size of the group. What is that red product term? To me, that's not C, B, A. So segment C logic is equal to not C, B, A. My final answer for that one. Let's move over and try segment D. Okay, there's a pretty challenging one here. What are the groups here? And let's go ahead and clean this up here so we don't confuse ourselves. What are the groups here? That one. Can I go any, are there any adjacent cells to that? Yeah, I could potentially go grab this guy, right? So I'm counting for 1 and for 9 in that particular case. Okay, so using, again, that wraparound adjacency from the top to the bottom, I can grab that one. What about that one? Nope, because again, use them if they help you, don't use them if they don't. Well, it might help me if I could grab this whole thing. Can I wrap around over here? No, nobody's there. What is my third product term? I'm going to grab this particular group right there. Some of you may want to do something like this. It's unnecessary, because again, maximize the size of the group, minimize the number of groups. Do I need to do that? Well, no, because I've already accounted for position 9 with my first group in red. Okay, so let's see if you can come up with the, let's do them all at once. Do red, blue, and green, and just come up with your final segment D answer. And let's see if you can come up with something that looks like this. There you go. My final minimized, fully minimized SOP expression is C, not B, not A, or not C, not B, A, or C, B, A. That's again for the D segment. And ultimately what you can do is make the segment A logic, segment B logic, C, D logic to basically perform exactly like that block diagram, D, C, B, A, MSB to LSB, and have segment A logic hooked up to that one, that output, B, C, and D. And then for further on exercises, you can do E, F, and G. Okay, this concludes the Unit 5 review. And what is the stuff that I reviewed? It's kind of the hard stuff, is just taking a nebulous statement and sticking it in a truth table. Once you've got the truth table, putting it in the K-map and minimizing the SOP expression. A lot of the things is just come up with all possible combinations of input and sit down and think about it. Every single combination. And you guys are so lucky, we're sticking at 4-bit combinations. I'm not going to go on to 5 or 6 or 7 or 8. This concludes the Unit 5 review.